Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the way to do the shell sort process. So in this process, we first sort the elements that are at some larger intervals, and then we sort the elements that are at some smaller intervals. And then we just repeat step 2, that means we just sort the elements that are at even smaller intervals, so that the interval becomes 1. Okay, let us see an example. Suppose we want to sort these numbers. How can we do that? By using shell sort. First, we need to determine the intervals to use. The first interval can be something like this. We try the division of the number of elements by 2, and then we just take the integer part of it. Now, there are 8 elements, so that n becomes 8. 8 divided by 2 gives me 4, and 8 divided by 2 gives me 4, and the integer part of quotient is also 4. So that means we just try to sort the elements that are 4 elements apart. So at the beginning, we have 6, and after 4 more elements, we have 2. And we have no further elements that are separated by 4 further elements. So we just need to sort the 2 numbers that are 2 and 6. The way to do the sorting can be insertion sort. So we are going to sort the 2 numbers in pink color by using insertion sort. How can we do the insertion sort? So first we need to put the value on the right hand side to the temp variable. After that we just put the left element to the right hand side, so that we simply do the copy action to copy 6 from the left hand side to the right hand side. Finally, we just put the temporary element to the left position. So in this case, 2 and 6 are swapped. Now after sorting using 4 elements as the interval sides, we see that the result is like this. 2 and 6 are simply interchanged, and other elements remain unchanged. Now we try the second round of the shell sort that uses n divided by 4 being the interval size. Now n equals 8, which is simply referring to the number of elements. And 8 divided by 4 gives me 2, and the integer part of 2 is simply equal to 2. So that means we just sort the elements that are 2 elements apart. Now we have 2 followed by 7, which is separated by 2 elements from 2. And after 7, we have 6, which is separated by 2 elements from 7. And after 6, we have 5, which is separated by 2 elements from 6. So now we have 2, 7, 6, and 5 to do the sorting. And again, we can use the insertion sort. The first idea is that we have to put 6 before 7. How can we do that? We can simply use the swapping technique that I showed you previously. First, we have to copy 6, which is this element on the right, to the temporary variable. And then we just copy the left-hand side element to the right-hand side. And then I just put temporary element to the left hand side, so that the swapping is complete. Now we have already swapped 6 and 7. So what remains is the element number 5, which should be put before 6. And we can see that the insertion sort has to consider 3 elements that are 6, 7, and 5. Now we simply put 5, that is the value to be inserted, to the temporary variable first. Then we copy 7 to the next position. Then we also copy 6 to the next position. And the result is that we can simply move 6 and 7 by 1 more element respectively. After that, I simply put the temporary variable to the position that is already vacated for it. So 5 becomes the first element out of 5, 6, and 7. So in this process, the insertion sort process is complete. Now after the sorting in this way, we can see that the elements are in this order, 2, 5, 6, and 7 for those which have experienced the sorting previously, and all other values remain unchanged. Now we go to the third interval to use, which is simply equal to n divided by 8, followed by taking the integer part. Now we have 8 elements, so that 8 divided by 8 is simply equal to 1, and the integer part of 1 is also 1. So what does it mean by that? We just do the insertion sort with 1 element being the interval. That means we just do the ordinary insertion sort. Now we see that one should come before two, so that's why we have to handle this sorting first. The idea is quite simple. We put one to the temporary variable, and then we copy two to the right hand side, so that the temporary variable can be copied to the left hand side. In this case, one and two are swapped. And then we see that 4 has to come before 5, so we have to take care of it by using the insertion sort process. Now 4 is put to the temporary variable, and then we copy 5 to the right hand side, and after that we can simply copy the temporary variable to the left hand side, so that 4 and 5 are interchanged. The next insertion sort is about 7, so we have to put 7 before 8. How can we do this insertion sort? We simply copy 7 to the temporary variable, and then we copy 8 to replace 7, and then we just copy the temporary variable to the left hand side, so that the original value of 8 becomes 7, and in this case the swapping is complete. We can see that 7 goes before 8. Okay, the final insertion sort involves moving 3 before 4. And you can see that it involves the relocation of a number of elements. First, we have to copy 3 to the temporary variable, and then we copy 8 to replace 3. After that, we simply copy 7 to the element, which is one more element on the right-hand side of it. And then we copy 6 to the element position, which is just one element on the right-hand side of it. And then we copy 5 to the next position. And also we have to copy 4 to one more position on the right-hand side of it. And now we can have the space for 3 to insert. We just copy 3 from the temporary variable to the original place of the value of 4. In this case, we can see that after the insertion sort process that involves one element being the interval, we can see that the order is already complete. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. In this case, we can say that the sorting process is complete. So what is the advantage of using the shell sort when we can simply use insertion sort? The advantage is like this. When there are a large number of elements, that is the case when we have tens or hundreds of elements, when we use larger intervals at the beginning, we can usually reduce the number of insertions to do when it comes to having the insertion sort with an interval of one element. And when we use the insertion sort, it is usually faster than using the pure insertion sort that involves the interval of one element alone. So when we do the insertion sort starting from larger intervals and ending with an interval of one, we usually have a faster result than the pure insertion sort of only one element being the interval. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.